Aruba, a tropical island full of sun, surf, and high-rise hotels. And if a new witness is to be believed, Natalee Holloway lies buried beneath one of them.
That one. It's called the Spyglass Tower, and it belongs to Marriott.
Urianne de Jong says on the night she vanished, he saw Joran Vandersloot bury Holloway at what was then just a construction site.
He made an opening in the cross under the foundation, and he pulled her by the ankles inside of the crawl space.
Eric Althoff is the new prosecutor on the island, and he has spent weeks investigating de Jong's information and determined it doesn't add up.
I don't know if he's lying. I can only say that his statement can't be true.
According to Aruban investigators, the night Natalee disappeared, construction of the Spyglass Tower hadn't started. The structures de Jong says he saw weren't there.
The Marriott says, looking at the date, the 30th of May 2005, there was no construction at the specific spot that Mr. de Jong pointed out.
No building, then no body. Then no way is de Jong's story true.
And then there is this, a satellite image from Google Earth taken in June 2005, just a few weeks after Natalee disappeared. And there's a construction site, and what appear to be the blurry outlines of structures. In a statement to CNN, Marriott says, Mr. de Jong has contacted Marriott in the past, and each time we have suggested to Mr. de Jong that he present his account of the matter to the authorities. As we have done all along, we cooperate fully with the authorities whenever they are conducting an official investigation. But the new investigation seems to rely almost entirely on Marriott's assertion there was no construction.
What if they're wrong?
Well, I think they're not wrong because they can prove it with some photographs and some other material.
Natalee Holloway's father led a number of ground searches in Aruba and remembers the site and believes it was never searched.
I was there on June 1st, and there was definitely construction in that area.
The prosecutor isn't the only one doubting de Jong. Joran Vandersloot doesn't think much of him either. Currently in a Peruvian jail convicted of murdering a young girl, he didn't call him a liar. Instead, speaking through his attorney, he called de Jong, quote, a crackhead. He says de Jong was a drug dealer and is only out for money.
Did he ever ask you for money?
No.
Have you ever asked from the Holloway family, from media, from anyone, money for the information you have?
No.
De Jong laughs it off, saying Vandersloot's angry because he's scared.
I think he's desperate. I mean, the only reason why he does that is that he's afraid that people are going to believe me.
So what happens now?
When we have concrete leads, concrete tips about the disappearance of Natalee Holloway, we will investigate it.
But Mr. de Jong is not one of those.
No, not Mr. de Jong is not adding to solve the case.
Are there any other leads?
Not at the moment.
Despite years of trying to convince someone he knows where Natalee is and who put her there, de Jong says, once again, nothing will happen.
It would damage the image of Aruba as one happy island.
We had a struggle with the Aruban authorities from the very beginning of this case.
Tom Fuentes oversaw the FBI's international operations in 2005. He says if Natalee's remains could be recovered, they might lead to determining a cause of death and a suspect.
Right now, not having that ability to do that leaves it open-ended, and it leaves it very difficult to be able to link Joran Vandersloot to foul play.
Are you guilty?
Joran Vandersloot has never been charged in connection with Natalee's disappearance and has maintained his innocence. Meanwhile, Dave Holloway's not giving up.
They've relied on some misinformation from the Marriott people.
He spent the last decade looking for his daughter, and he says de Jong's information is his best lead in years.
It seems to fit.
It seems to fit, yeah. A lot of it seems to fit. And it's causing me a lot of anxiety.
Martin, to do a thorough search of this Spyglass Tower building, do we know what that would be, what would be required?
Dave Holloway, who has been looking into this, of course, he says that it wouldn't require much at all, really. All that is needed is to find a cadaver dog, bring it onto the island, and probably just drill a few holes into the foundation of this building. It would be quick, it would be simple, and it wouldn't require any demolition at all.
So why won't authorities, Martin, just do that?
It seems like such a simple thing to do, but the prosecutor says the reason is because he doesn't want to give people false hope, doesn't want to give the Holloway family false hope, doesn't want to give all the Americans and others who followed this story false hope, because the prosecutor is adamant. She is not there. Wolf.